This feels like not a change of pace for Dark Castle, but a slight change up with a more of a suspenseful Hitchcockian thriller. Was that something that you were interested in pursuing?
Well, the idea for Dark Castle was meant to be a genre label, you know, not necessarily horror movies. I mean, the first picture out was Rock and Rolla, which was, you know, it was a different than the movies before it. And, you know, and I think that this fit into our, it's a genre film. It's not a horror movie, but it's a suspense thriller. And it's one that is made affordably and was filmed in a fashion that allowed it to be done for the kind of the budgets that we have to work with Dark Castle. And I'm really proud of the movie. I think it's going to be a big success for us. I hope so. And it's really, I'm very happy with the picture. I think that it's this is the direction we should be going in my opinion.
Obviously, Liam sort of has taken under his belt. Was there a concern to sort of make this definitely different from that and different from many of the films that have sort of been big in the genre?
I mean, it has a feeling of Bourne Identity, I think. It has a feeling of The Fugitive. It has definitely a feeling of Taken. I mean, you know, it has a feeling of Frantic, the Polanski picture. I mean, I think that it, you know, those thrillers, you know, are, you know, I mean, look, it has a feeling of The 3 Days of the Condor. I mean, those kind of political-type thrillers or identity-type thrillers are very compelling. And I think this movie is compelling, and I think it takes you on a really wild ride, and I think like those films, it you know, it works. I mean, this movie has this incredible twist that you don't really see coming, and I think that's one of our biggest selling points, this really great finish that is just a big surprise.
If you were to be sort of stuck in a similar situation as Dr. Harris finds himself, how do you think you would react?
Oh boy, I mean, you know, I'm the kind of guy that has problems with loss of control, you know. Mm-hmm. This would really, really send me through a loop, you know. I mean, I don't know what I would do, but I hope I would do as well as Liam does.
So do you think you'd find a way to find a gun and kick some ass?
I don't know. Who knows? I mean, you know, Liam can handle all that stuff. I'm not sure I know how to do that, but I would try.
Okay. You've got a load of sort of projects sort of coming up. What's next on the agenda for you?
The next movie up is a movie called The Apparition. We did another Dark Castle film we did with Ashley Green, who's in the Twilight movies, and Sebastian Stan. And it's a very, it's a scary movie, horror movie, a ghost story. I have a movie we just did with Todd Phillips. He produced with us called Project X, which is a really wild kind of R-rated comedy, which is sensational. And we just finished shooting Sherlock, you know, the sequel, which we finished on Friday night and will come out in December. And, you know, we got a lot going on. We're busy, but it's a good time. But we're focusing now on Unknown, because we want that movie to do what it has to do worldwide.